Guys.
Hi everyone.
Here she is, she's just grabbing a bite to eat.
I'm just getting a drink,
just
hang on.
Grabbing a drink. Could you grab me a ginger beer from the fridge? Thanks. In true Johnny Depp fashion, not a beer, but a ginger beer. Look, there's Baby Yoda. There's Baby Yoda. Hi guys, hope you're all well. Sorry that we've probably interrupted you watching the vlog. And it's a far-reaching vlog. But for those of you who've come for the Johnny Depp story, of course, it's the big, quite remarkable, kind of, this has sort of crept up on all of us, really, this Johnny Depp story. Let's ask, first of all, what are your takes on Johnny Depp? Are you a Johnny Depp fan, yes or no? Are you a Johnny Depp fan, yes or no? Evening, Rebecca Holland. What are we? Are we no, yes, no, yes, 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 yes. Oh, lots of yes, more yeses, I'd say, than noes. Yes, not really, Mama Gilly. Yes. You know, as a family, we've been a huge Johnny. I think I wouldn't be compromising Maddie's anonymity if I didn't say that he was one of her first sort of star crushes alongside Leonardo DiCaprio. I mean, Nadia, I'm sure she'll qualify this when she comes, has never been, in terms of him as an actor, I mean, I first came across him in What's Eating Gilbert Grape. Does anyone remember that film, What's Eating Gilbert Grape? And things like Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas and stuff like that.
Hiya.
I was just saying, just doing a straw poll, the majority of people are sort of fans of Johnny Depp. So I was just saying that Maddie was always probably one of her sort of first idol star crushes, wasn't he?
Oh my God, she loved him.
I mean, she loved him. And Pirates of the Caribbean has always been an incredibly important franchise for us as a family, you know, the music and also the comedy and the silliness of it, as was The Lone Ranger, which is something else that people don't often think about. But you've never been a particular fan of his acting, have you?
Not of his acting at all, but I really like, I've always liked him.
Yeah, there's something about him. What is it?
He has great charm. We know somebody that knows somebody.
Yeah, who's very good friends with him.
Who's very good friends with him.
Yeah.
And says he's the most charming and the most generous of people. Boy, does he love to party.
Mm-hmm.
You can't keep up with him.
No.
But he's a very, very lovely man. Of course, we cannot draw judgment on anything that's being said here because how can we know?
Yeah.
It's two people in a marriage saying two completely different things about each other. And as we all know, there's nearly always, you know, two sides, two stories, two people to blame in two different ways.
And it's not really our place to get involved in that, because in a weird way, it's a libel case. This isn't about whether he's not being tried on whether he's done something illegal or not. I mean, clearly he's done a lot that's illegal. Mm. He's taken every drug there is to be considered on the planet, and he's drunk pints and pints of whiskey, and he's obviously got demons. He's obviously got demons.
Did he say in the court case that he actually started taking drugs at 11 years old?
He started taking drugs at 11. He, you know, puts it down to a very traumatic childhood, difficulty with his parents and what have you.
What kind of childhood? He didn't know anything about his childhood.
I think you could argue how difficult compared to anyone's. I mean, I think merely the fact that he was estranged from one of his parents and just, you know, a lack of security, a lack of consistent care. He was, you know, another one of those cases where a little bit like the Drew Barrymore, where his, you know, his engagement, he engaged with drugs at a ludicrously young age.
God, I mean, Drew Barrymore, that's another one. I've interviewed her. She's just adorable. She was being taken to clubs at 9 years old.
Yeah.
She's actually divorced her parents completely. Do you know that?
Has she?
Legally.
She's legally divorced her
parents. Well, I don't know what the actual terminology for it is, but basically it means she's divorced them.
Well, I mean, the reason it's important to Johnny Depp is that he feels that the Sun and Dan Wooten specifically have libeled him. And what they've done simply, the newspapers, is they've repeated the claims of his ex-wife.
Emancipated, thank you, Xander.
His ex-wife, Amber Heard, who's describing him as a wife-beater. And he feels that this is libelous and is a slur on his character and what have you. And he's wanting to and so, now, most people in the UK, most celebrities know that you don't take the newspapers to court on a libel case.
Never goes well.
It never really runs well. And I can only think, as you
and I mean, I know many people over the years who've had terrible things said about them that aren't true, and they say, we won't take them
to
court.
We won't bother. Now,
why is that?
Now, how much of a bottomless pit of money has Johnny Depp got? I mean, we know that we've often heard it reported what he spent his money on. we've heard is an incredibly generous person. Mm. I mean, he, you know, if you, people who know him say, if you say something you like of his, he'll give you it. I mean, he's a very, you know, and that's the way often with an addictive personality, isn't it? So it's less about, it's less about the rights and wrongs of what's going on. It's just the fact that what strikes me as really sad about the whole story as a recovering addict, Alky, is that he's sitting there in that very unusual way that he has these days, which is very calm, and he's answering everything that's put to him very politely and very measuredly.
Well, I was just reading some of the court documents, and he... I don't know whether what he's doing is very clever,
or whether it is just...
But he is absolutely naivety. Telling the truth.
Yes.
Like, well, answering the most intrusive, personal questions. And he's admitting,
Or he's even saying, when he's being accused of saying the most awful things, he's saying there are situations in which I could have said that.
But I didn't say it at that point. Yeah. Yes, that could be. That probably is a pill box full of my pills.
Yeah.
Yes. And I don't know how the law works, but I was saying to you, wasn't it? Does this mean that he won't be believed because he does all these things? Or will it mean that when he does say no, people will believe him because of the incredible things he said yes to?
Could it be a double, not bluff?
I don't think it's a bluff, but from what I hear about him, he seems so,
and I say this in the most generous way, because, you know, I understand what it means to be off the wagon, so to speak, but he seems so sort of dislocated from reality, to put it politely. Through possibly overindulgence, through whatever he's taking to keep himself on an even keel, that I don't think he's got the sophistication of and rapidity of thought to lie. Do you know what I mean?
But again, we have no idea, and God knows. Yeah. You know, I mean, maybe he did batter. We just don't.
Well, here's the thing. I mean, for example, in one instance where I think they were on a private jet, and the accusation is that he freaked out about Amber Heard acting with James Franco. And let's not forget, James Franco's had all of this stuff about his alleged sort of grooming of young actresses who he was teaching to act by being too sort of lascivious with them and things like that. You know, James Franco's come under the spotlight for his own behaviour, hasn't he? Well, on a flight...
James Franco, I
can't remember. Well, James Franco is an actor from The Disaster Artist. I can't think what his most famous role is. But, I mean, The Disaster Artist is what really kind of cut through all the sort of mud last year or 2 years ago. But anyway, no, so Johnny Depp sort of... The accusation was that he freaked out that Franco was making advances towards Amber Heard, and he freaked out to such an extent...
Everyone's saying there's something wrong with the video. There's quite a few people saying it. Oh. It's very blurry and poor.
Oh yeah, no, it will hopefully come back. It does sort of shift.
It might settle in a minute.
Yeah, it might settle and shift back in. Mm. Can I pull that back up? So there was this suggestion that he'd kind of kicked a chair. And anyway, so going back to your thing that he's opening up about stuff.
Mm.
He said, yes, I could have kicked a chair, but on that plane, if you kicked a chair, the chair wouldn't have spun round. I mean, he's giving such sort of specific detail.
Well, he said, I've never seen a chair...
On a plane. ...on a
plane be able to spin round and hurt somebody else.
Yeah.
So he's being very specific.
He's being very specific. But at the same time, what's happening is a little bit like a wildfire... he is kind of, he's incriminating more and more, not incriminating, but he's bringing more and more people into it. So Paul Bettany, who is an actor, he played the villain in Solo. He's the guy with the jewel in his head in the Avengers films. He's a very good friend of his and a drug-taking buddy. You know, and he's talked about him, not in particular...
Do you think his friend's all right with him saying who they've taken drugs with? Because he says,
Paul Bettany's being called as a witness. But him and Paul Bettany have sent texts to each other saying that they were going to microwave her dog, and that they were going to burn her. And I mean, they were saying this was said in sort of jokiness, a sort of dark gallows jokiness. Let's burn her or throw her in a pool. But I mean, the problem is that he's having to. I suppose he feels he has to be clean about this stuff.
He says Nadia, she abused him so badly, and he tried to protect her. Please listen to latest tapes. They're on tube. No. I mean, I'm just trying to give the balance, because you always have to say, maybe it's true. I mean, if I'm honest, my heart is with Johnny.
Yeah.
But we don't know, so we do have to. And yes, these tapes are horrendous. But I think the thing is, even a good person can behave very badly in a relationship. So I just think we have to be mindful of giving the balance.
No, I agree.
Because we do not know. They are in court and nobody in court knows. So for sure, so we have to...
I mean, there's all sorts of things about this that if you come... Again, it goes back to this thing we were talking about in Coffee Moaning this morning. If you sit too far on one side of what you'll say, what your hunch is, you could be accused of excusing someone who's done something wrong. I have to say, if I was defending Johnny Depp and I saw the photo, did you see the photo of his paraphernalia, drug paraphernalia? There it is there.
But you know what I think about that? It looks very set out.
Precisely my point.
I mean, that's
like
not the table
that's not the table of an out-of-control addict.
I mean, everything is so just so happens to be his driving light. So we can't.
But at the same time, it does strike... Plus Keith Richards' CD to prove something. It seems far too neatly... I tell you what, that is too neat a drug taking table.
What's he said about this table? He said, yes, that's my box.
He said, yes, it's probably had cocaine in it at some point. He said, that is probably a pint of whiskey. Do you know what? I don't think whiskey drinkers necessarily pour pints of whiskey.
Well, I don't know, but a chronic alcohol.
And then there's a shot of him collapsed on the floor.
Well, it breaks my heart,
in his bedroom.
That picture.
Now, when I saw this image, I just thought, oh, shitting hell. You know, I mean, this is the problem with addiction. Everything he's saying might be true. If everything that he's saying did happen and he did lose his temper, losing your temper doesn't mean you're a wife beater. Kicking a chair doesn't mean you're a wife beater. But if you've done all of these drink and drugs, you can see that the son, the prosecutors, are trying to paint him as such an unreliable witness. How can he in any way pretend to know what it is that he's done?
But the thing is, if you are like in the chaos that he is in, because he is an addict, I mean, there's no two ways about that. That's for sure. He's a chaotic addict. But I just think it's such a dangerous thing to do to go to court. He must just feel his innocence.
Yeah.
He must feel his innocence. I'm not saying he is innocent. And of course, I'm just trying to give the balance here because we can't be, you know, one sided because we don't know. But you kind of feel it's like Faith Goodman says, if I was innocent, I would want to shout it from the rooftops.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
So think, yes, he's drunk and took drugs. But why are there no photos of her injuries? Well, there are some photos.
Yeah, but they've been queried and questioned in terms of timelines and stuff like that. It's a very interesting point you make, though, that the very fact that he's willing to air all of this, it goes to the very heart of how absolutely willing he is to sort of show, you know,
I mean, what celebrities usually do is absolutely lock down.
Yeah, absolutely.
And say nothing. And that would have been the advice given to him by right and centre. Yeah.
I do, Ryan Fleming, remember Johnny Depp's first appearance in A Nightmare on Elm Street. Funny you should say that. I do absolutely remember that.
Thank you, Sue.
But, you know, there are elements to this story that smack of, you know, his sort of idol and someone who became a sort of father figure almost to him was Hunter S. Thompson, who wrote Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. You know, the crazed American author / gonzo journalist who just drank everything and took everything in the world about whom really Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas was based on. But when you start to hear stories of him holding a Yorkshire Terrier out of a car window...
I don't think he would. No, it was her dog
that he was holding out and laughing insanely.
Allegedly.
Now,
is there a film of that? That's still allegedly.
Well, that's my point. Again, allegedly. But even the images that are being painted of Johnny Depp's excesses reek of the fictional Johnny in Fear and Loathing in Las Vegas. That's the kind of thing that would have happened in that movie. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
But yeah, so it's for saying all this.
Gabrielle says Johnny Depp is just going to make the media attention to himself and his family worse. But I think that's what is interesting about this.
Yeah.
He's been an A-lister star for so many years. He will know exactly how much attention it would get. But one can assume, I suppose, that it means so much to him that he's willing to take that risk.
Yeah.
I mean, she looks very comfortable and confident at the court and very happy and at ease. So,
I mean, I guess she's not under... I mean, I presume she's going to give testimony.
But she's just been called because it's not a court case between him and her.
No,
that's important.
Yeah, it's a court case between him and the son and Dan Wooden. Specifically.
So does she have to be there? Is she subpoenaed?
I think the son have called her as a witness.
Wow.
I think the son have called her as a witness.
This is so deeply huge.
And I think it has the potential
to... Apparently it's going to go on for 3 weeks.
Well, it's 3 weeks. Yeah, we've got Winona Ryder coming in. We've got Vanessa Paradis coming in. There are reports, and they were talked about today in court, that Johnny Depp's daughter has been apparently sort of, you know, recorded, or there's an email or text or conversations with her saying that she thought Amber Heard was good for him.
Yeah.
That she was trying to.
And he has said, yes, she did say that. At
yeah,
the time.
I mean, he's been very honest about this.
Your drinking has got better. Yeah. You're a better dad to me, and yeah. I can't remember her brother's name.
I just worry. For me, the biggest worry I've got with this whole thing is that we could see, and I don't know if it.
CD, the Sun barristers are conflating his behaviour and
addiction, of course,
along with his filmed aggression with wife beating. So where is the busted jaws, arms, hospitalisation of Heard?
I think they're going to get to that.
The broken, there was broken up, jaws and
no,
arms?
No, no, what CD is saying is, come on, where's the evidence of busted jaws, arms and hospitalisation?
No, but is that what she's accused him of? No.
No, I
that
mean
he
she,
broke her arm.
No, she has. No. She's come out with. She suggested that he bruised her face, but there
she
are makeup.
She hasn't said that he broke her arm.
I don't know. I don't think so. No, but I mean, I think what CD is saying there is, come on, give us the evidence rather than the supposition. You can easily construct the idea.
But playing devil's advocate, there isn't always evidence.
No, true.
There isn't
true.
Always. You know, you've got to remember that these are movie stars.
True, Geraldine McCown.
Do you go to
domestic violence isn't always physical.
Exactly.
Right.
And do you always go to hospital if you're a victim of domestic violence and you're a movie star and everyone's going to talk about it? So I don't think it means that it didn't happen.
This could go to the very.
We will never know.
Steph Schultz says she apparently stubbed a cigarette on his face. I mean, this could go to the very
yeah,
heart of
that.
What constitutes why. You know, if it are we going to be talking about the terms of wife beating versus domestic abuse? You know, you could argue that living with any of that sort of reign of terror of an addict is monstrous and is intimidating and is abusive. In a sense, couldn't you? You could say that, you know, a man punching, as he did in the trailer, punching a mirror in the Art Deco trailer and leaving the trailer completely wrecked is a threatening and frightening situation. If a man does that in the presence of a woman, is he exerting an abusive, you know, sort of situation? I mean, it's a good question, isn't it?
Steph says, Johnny's daughter rang the cops on them while in the house. She said she feared for her dad's life as Heard was uncontrollable and physical with Johnny.
Wow. Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know that.
No, I haven't heard
oh,
that.
Oh,
we'll
bit. Have to look that one
well,
up.
Well, no, no. I mean, again, all of this stuff is dribbling out. This is the stuff to come. So what we've just had from the 2 days so far, the most heartbreaking part of the whole 2 days in court was Johnny Depp's email or message to Elton John when he had something like 100 days of sobriety, saying, thank you for getting the monster off my back.
God.
Which the Sun quickly turned round to saying, so that monster is the monster that Amber Heard
right.
is referring
yeah,
to.
Yeah, you see a lawyer. You can't. Any good lawyer is going to use that, aren't they?
Yeah.
Miranda, a survivor, says there is audio evidence of her admitting abusing him because they recorded a lot of their phone calls.
Yeah,
didn't
that's
they?
Right, that's right. And so yeah, so I mean, all of this is going to be trotting out and sort of dribbling out as we go. The whole story is interesting. I feel so bad for his kids. It would be terrible to see your dad going through that.
Awful.
I mean,
awful.
I
really do feel sorry for everyone in this case.
Yeah.
Even if. What Amber Heard says is not true. It is not easy being married to an addict of that level. Do you know what I mean? Life.
No.
And of course, we're not going to find out about what her addictions were because we don't know if they were similar addicts. We don't know. I know he cross accuses
well,
with that.
He claims she dabbed cocaine onto her gums.
Yeah.
And he claimed that she was extraordinarily...
She
well, he also claimed that she was extraordinarily keen on putting lines of cocaine out for him.
Yes, that's what he says. He says she used to chop them out.
I mean, you could have a situation where she was gaslighting. Could there be? You can easily gaslight someone who's that off their tits.
But then easily you can have somebody that imagines all these things because they're,
they're deluded
and
struggling with addiction. I mean, my worry is that a prejudgment will be made of Johnny based on his absolutely out of control, wild Keith Richards style
but,
lifestyle.
You know, some would say that is the knox that you take if you live an addict's life. I mean, I think this is a terribly sad case for everyone involved, especially more than anyone else, his kids.
He has accused...
His kids are just... Imagine this. Imagine seeing these photos of
your
dad.
No, no, that's awful.
I mean, it's just awful.
I mean, he has accused her. I think the description used was she has a sort of compulsive, psychopathic, narcissistic, sociopathic personality.
This is what he said.
This is how he's described
her. I think she says the same of him, doesn't she? She?
I mean,
she say the same of him?
As a mudslinging exercise, it's going to get extraordinarily... I'm most fascinated to see what Paul Bettany says when he comes in.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Rach, please read absolutely everything available. We are going to be... But what we're going to be doing with this is is responding to things that have been said in court
yeah.
that day.
Yeah,
this
we know...
is very much going to be what the court said
yeah.
verbatim, because we don't want to be...
Yeah, we're kind of wanting to run through it chronologically. We
yeah.
know lots of stuff that's in the public sphere and public air, you know, in the public. but yeah, someone was just saying there that, incidentally, if he wins this case, he may pursue Amber Heard for criminal charges afterwards.
Really?
Yeah, so... I've heard that.
I mean, he means business, doesn't
yeah,
he?
He really means business. And the other thing that's at the back of this, I've you know, I sense, is that I think I mentioned before, is that he is, you know, he does need to clear his name, because no other film he's appeared in has been a hit. I mean, his Pirates of the Caribbean is his last sort of franchise. His earning potential has completely diminished. Okay, he's still extraordinarily wealthy. He still gets revenue from Pirates of the Caribbean. But he does need to be able to still work to maintain this lifestyle.
Mm.
He does talk rather tragically about how delusion, he was talking about this yesterday, how hard it is to actually comprehend himself anymore because of his level of fame. He says, even when I hear my name said in other people's mouths, I don't relate to the person they're talking about. And that's a kind of out-of-body weirdness that I don't think any of us can fully comprehend. So if he's a vulnerable addict, he would be he could be an easy target. Do you know what I mean? I mean, I think there is that thing about, you know, a lot of people in couples, I can think of several cases myself where people have been encouraged to drink because the one partner knows that they have a bit of a kind of weakness for alcohol, and it's used as kind of cover to then blame them for this, that, and the other. So you can easily gaslight an addict, for sure.
Xander Gibbs says, I bet the son are paying her to appear. Can you do that? Can you pay someone to appear at court?
I wonder.
Michael Augustin Reed, listen to the calls between Johnny and her parents. They said she was horrible volunteering. Volunteering?
Volunteering.
We should listen to those calls.
Yeah, we should. Yeah, absolutely. I wish he'd
Geraldine McEwen, he was never the same after appearing on French and Saunders.
I once got a moment. I got a moment's soundbite from him at the Cannes Film Festival. He had such a star quality about him.
Was well, young, you saw him.
He was lithe. I'm trying to remember what the film might have been. He was with, I think, Vanessa Paradis. It was at the Cannes Film Festival. They were coming through this. It's the madness of Cannes. It's got to be done as a film. But we were kind of given a tip off, and then we went down into this place, and there was an entry walk into a hotel. And there he was coming through all the paparazzi, and we shouted one question at him, and he gave us an eye. I can't remember what it was about.
Well, somebody I used to work with was at a club where there was a VIP room. This person I'm talking about is a VIP. And she said, quite extraordinary between him and Kate Moss, what she saw.
Oh, yeah. No, that's right. It was his...
Don't forget, he went out with Kate Moss for years.
That's right, yeah. It was his personal doctor who suggested she was a sociopathic narcissist.
That's right.
He said it was a counsellor.
But his personal doctor.
But yeah, absolutely.
That's what we've got to remember here.
Yeah. I mean, you know, he does struggle.
I don't have an opinion. I don't know who's telling the truth. I mean, I really don't.
I don't.
Oh my God, she's a liar, he's a liar. I think that we just have to wait. We have to let this unfold.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, there you go, guys. We're going to keep updating on this story because it really is going to get bigger and bigger. And once you've seen what's come out in these 2 days, the photos, the accusations, the James Franco, the so-called violence in the jets and all this kind of stuff. Marilyn Manson going on a cocaine bender after allegedly dropping Lily Rose off at school.
Yeah,
again,
well, she does admit to dropping her off at school with Manson.
Marilyn Manson and Johnny Depp dropped his daughter off at school. Bloody hell. So I think Marilyn Manson's being called as a witness as well.
God.
I mean, all the character witnesses that are coming in for Johnny Depp. I was curious to know whether Helena Bonham Carter might be called in as
she
well.
She may. They're great friends,
Tim Burton.
Yeah.
I mean, Tim Burton's worked with him on everything.
Passive aggressive, the fact that he's willing to allow everything private. Reading Court must speak to his convictions. His life on the line. He was dropped by Warner Brothers while Amber still gets
it. It must be
like
very
that.
Hard. And don't you think there's a deep irony that the two of them are most famous? She is now most famous for Aquaman for two franchises based on the seas, on the high seas. There's something very odd about.
What is she like? Is she a good actress?
No, I mean,
I've never seen her.
Aquaman, it's hardly. Certainly, it was no Pirates of the Caribbean, that's for sure.
There are always two sides of the story, and we just hope the truth can prevail.
But I think there's going to be a remarkable... I'm curious to know who else the Sun are going to bring in as character witnesses against Johnny Depp. That's what I'm fascinated to know. Yeah.
I wonder who that would be. Who do we know that he's come up against?
Don't know. But yeah, watch this space. We'll be updating on the Popcorn Junkies Instagram account. We'll be following this. And as I say, you know, we are not judging or prejudging anyone. We're seeing it as it comes up in this case.
Yeah, we want to see it as it comes, and we'll just be talking about it.
Okay.
But as we've said, it's a very sad story for everybody.
It is. And for me, the addict side of it, either you, like you say, he's either playing a blinder in that he's just going to be honest about everything. Mm.
And maybe he's just decided, you know what, the only way I'm going to play this is with a straight bat.
Mm.
I'm going to be honest as I can.
Yeah.
But the trouble is then when you see him passed out and he says, oh, yeah, I do quite often pass out around toilets and stuff, you know.
And also, you know, we know that the mind and manipulativeness of an addict will say anything sometimes. So, you know, it's you'll go one way in order to come back the other. I mean, it's a tricky one. Okay, guys.
Real domestic abuse victims are the losers in this, says Mel W.
Very true.
And we don't know if this is a lie. It is a terrible.
Oh my God.
Terrible situation for all the millions of people, men and women, that suffer.
But the problem with sociopathic narcissism, if that was a thing in any of this, is, and the problem with addiction. So let's say those are the two potential sort of polemic sides of the two characters. They aren't necessarily even coming from a position of feeling they're lying.
Yeah.
They're coming from a position of this is the truth.
Yeah, yeah.
And that is how difficult. What is your barometer on truth then?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? It's impossible. Yeah. All right, guys. We'll see you on the non.
We shall see you.
Go to our vlog straight after this. It should pop up straight after this.
Yeah, and please subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. We have all sorts of things going on the channel. Have a scoot around it because we don't just do this stuff.
No.
We do vlogs, we do lives, we do cookery, movie reviews with cookery, we do TV reviews.
You name it. And pop lots of your details down below. Tell us where to go to see more information, though we are only going to be reacting to what comes up in this court case.
And if you could hit the thumbs up.
Yeah,
for us, just a thumbs up.
It's just
we're
under
at 116 now.
Yeah, go on, get us to 200.
Yeah, that'd be nice. Oh, there we go. I love it when you see it go pop, pop, pop.
It goes pop, 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 pop. And there it goes pop, pop, pop again. Oh, all right, guys. Lots of love and see you tomorrow.